And we know that the reason that the tribes of Israel were being scattered was because of their sin, because they became involved in the Babylonian religions, such as Freemasonry.
O Lord, my God, is there no help for the widow's son? Brother Senior Grand Warden, take the body by the entered apprentice's grip and see if it can be raised.
Most worshipful King Solomon, the body cannot be raised by the entered apprentice's grip. The skin slips from the flesh.
Take it by the fellowcraft's grip and see if it can be raised.
For reasons already assigned, it cannot be raised by the fellowcraft grip. The flesh cleaves from the bone.
In this our extremity, what should we do?
Let's pray.
Okay, at this point, we will eliminate the prayer.
And so the reason I showed you that clip was because of the reference to King Solomon, who was the person taking that ritual there of the third degree of Hiram Abiff, who was the one lying on the floor. And the original three grand masters of Freemasonry, King Solomon, King Hiram, and Hiram Abiff, the architect. And so this is a ritual that's part of Freemasonry today and was the cause of the split up of Israel and also of its dispersion through the nations. And so this is a religion that God hates. And so let's have a look now at King Solomon and what happened to him. King Solomon loved many foreign women besides Pharaoh's daughter, Moabites, Ammonites, Edomites, Sidonians, and Hittites. They were from nations about Israel, which the Lord had told the Israelites, "You must not intermarry with them, because they will surely turn your hearts after their gods." Nevertheless, Solomon held fast to them in love. He had 700 wives of royal birth and 300 concubines, and his wives led him astray. As Solomon grew old, his wives turned his heart after other gods, and his heart was not fully devoted to the Lord his God, as the heart of David his father had been. He followed Ashtoreth, the goddess of the Sidonians, and Molech, the detestable god of the Ammonites. So Solomon did evil in the eyes of the Lord, and he did not follow the Lord completely, as David his father had done. On a hill east of Jerusalem, Solomon built a high place for Chemosh, the detestable god of Moab, and for Molech, the detestable god of the Ammonites. He did the same for all his foreign wives, who burned incense and offered sacrifices to their gods. The Lord became angry with Solomon, because his heart had turned away from the Lord, the God of Israel, who had appeared to him twice. Although he had forbidden Solomon to follow other gods, Solomon did not keep the Lord's command. So the Lord said to Solomon, "Since this is your attitude, and you have not kept my covenant and my decrees, which I commanded you, I will most certainly tear the kingdom away from you and give it to one of your subordinates. Nevertheless, for the sake of David, your father, I will not do it during your lifetime. I will tear it out of the hand of your son, yet I will not tear the whole kingdom from him, but will give him one tribe for the sake of David, my servant, and for the sake of Jerusalem, which I have chosen." And so this is where the division between the northern and southern tribes of Israel took place, all because of the actions of King Solomon. And the havoc that Freemasonry brought to Israel was huge, as successive kings came, and some supported God Almighty and some supported the gods of wood and stone of the Babylonian religions.